welcome to Joburg Today. I'm Zizi Pondevu. One of the unique attributes to Joburg is our graffiti. We caught up with graffiti artist Mars to find out a bit more.
One of the most interesting things about Joburg is the graffiti around it. So we speak to one of the artists that are responsible for this form of art.
Graffiti is not just something that's sprayed on a wall. I mean, the art industry is not just pretty pictures to look at. It's an industry after all. You know, you can make money off of this, and there is money to be made, you know, so people are starting to see the value of it, as well as the social value of, like, this is our people, this is what they have to say, and it's kind of been, you know, documented throughout the city. I mean, if, like you said, the TAPS tag is as part of Johannesburg as the Ponte Tower at this point, because everywhere you go you'll see one, and for the past 10 years it's been there, you know what I mean? Graffiti's kind of new in the city of Joburg. I think it's being sort of in between first and third world. Graffiti came here kind of late compared to first world countries. Most of the time the public are very receptive to it, and that's okay, because then, you know, no one calls the police, and, you know, we work with permission, so we'd ask maybe the owner of the building, can we paint your wall? And then we'd get other people from the community asking as well, like, you know, don't you want to do our wall? Once they see sort of the end product, they're happy with that. There's guys who just do the tags, and there's guys who do like the simple silver graffitis, and there's guys who do the full murals, and there's guys who just paint graffiti on large scale. You wouldn't even think that this is maybe even graffiti, just because there's not the graffiti letters and elements, you know. So it's more of like an abstract sort of art form that I'm kind of like starting to do now, and it's more like for gallery spaces and these sort of things.
Graffiti is a growing form of art within the city of Johannesburg. So whenever you see those different colors or a signature on your wall, don't be upset about it, just embrace it. I'm Buitumela Ratokwena for Joburg Today.
My name is Kanja Aitz, and you're watching Joburg Today.
Join the conversation on our Facebook page, that's joburgtoday.tv. Follow us on Twitter at joburgtoday. And if you're one of those people on the move, then pockettv.mobi. That's pocket with an I. What happens when you put a camera in the hands of a child? You get the story of I Was Shot in Joburg.
It started off basically as a very small project. I did with a group of boys who used to live with Twilight Children, a shelter for former street children in Heelbrow. I gave them disposable cameras, and we had a class every week to either take photographs of the immediate environment or discuss the photographs. And as the images started coming back from the lab, we were all extremely excited. I mean, they were naive yet very real.
The first time where I hold my disposable camera. So like in my mind is there were thoughts going like, okay, now I'm handling a camera, like I'm supposed to do like some productive work. But at the first time I was like intimidating this project. But when time went on, I met some other guys, then we started taking some few pics while we were walking. Then I learned more, like there's more to it. An actual photo that we take, there's a story behind it.
I got involved with this company in the beginning of 2009, which is 4.5 years ago. And what happened, like there's a guy, Bernard Fulion, the founder of the company. He came to the shelter and asked if we are interested in learning how to photography. I was one of the first group that were taken through the photography course that took us about 6 months. And after that, we had to exhibit our work that we have been doing all the way through. They are actually our first exhibition that we had in 2009. And some of them are mine, and there are some that I really like. This one, that's my hand. People liked the concept and even bought some of our canvases, and after that we decided we need to grow the project and make it as a business so that we can make income out of it.
They basically when I came with the cameras, started going around. It was like on the Mondays, we called it on the Mondays afternoon.
Most of the pictures, if you might look, they are from the CBD and Hillbro, and actually they explain life in Joburg. So yeah, it's all about like life, the street life of Joburg, how people live, and actually our everyday life in Joburg.
Hi, I'm Masura Meyer, and you are watching Joburg Today.
I love the elegance and the storytelling that comes through ballet. We caught up with Joburg Ballet to see what makes them a world-class company.
Joburg Ballet is a new company that actually an old beginning. And it's a company that has come to being by merging the South African Ballet Theatre and Mzansi Productions, and became SA Mzansi Ballet. Now we call the Joburg Ballet because we are very fortunate to receive funding from the city of Joburg.
Ballet is becoming hot, and it's what people want to do, what people want to see. I even read an article the other day about adverts at the moment. The trend is ballet. So I think we're really at the right place at the right time now. And I think it's been around for centuries, and I think we're going to stay into the future for the next centuries to come.
Ballet is inspirational, aspirational, and we take it to kids in Soweto, we went to Seri Beng, and no matter where you are, whether you're in Cuba, in Paris, in New York, and in Johannesburg, the trend is ballet is hot, and we're part of it, and Joburg Ballet is ensuring that Joburg follows the international trend.
I've danced in several countries overseas before, and we don't have to stand back for anybody. Joburg Ballet's standard is fantastic.
We are doing what the rest of the world is doing, and we're trying very hard to ensure that we give this world-class African ballet company a space and a place where we fit on the world stage.
Hi, I'm Roxanne Rademeyer, and you're watching Joburg Today.
For more stories on the city, check out our special focus section, as well as Joburg in Your Pocket for all that's happening in and around Johannesburg. That's it from me, Zizi. I leave you with Rubber Duck, Screw Loop.
Back in ETV.
I got a screw loose in my shoe. I got a screw loose just for you. I got a screw loose for Cape Town. And when you find me on the street, with a screw loose in my feet, you know. Cape Town's my playground, my playground. I got a screw loose in my head. 10 shots, knock, knock, who's there? On the rocks we roll through Cape Town. And I say, sweet, so it's a crime to drink whiskey mixed with lime. All this time we fight for one more night, we fight. Please don't take this offbeat from this street. Please save my soul. Put this screw back in my shoe. And please don't stop it. I won't stop until my heart stops loving you. I got a screw loose in my shoe. I got a screw loose just for you, and oh how the city waits for the showdown. Between the wheel and the floor, between the Zep folk and the door. All this time we fight for one more night, we fight. Please don't take this offbeat from this street. Please save my soul. Put the screw back in my shoe. And please don't stop it. I won't stop until my heart stops loving you. We'll be right back. got a screw loose in my shoe. I got a screw loose just for you. I got a screw loose for Cape Town. And please don't take these old feet from this street. Please save my soul. Put the screw back in my shoe. And please don't stop it. I won't stop until my heart stops loving you.